I liked to draw. I drew in albums, in the margins, and sometimes I even made sketches with the pencil in school books. Once upon a time, I even wanted to become an animator. By the way, I learned a little about animation, but drawing didn't go further than children's drawings. And now I got acquainted with the sketch crawler game. The creator of the game is Oleksiy Sityanov, lead game designer of the legendary Stalker Shadow of Chernobyl by GSC Game World, Metro Games by 4A Games. He was also a screenwriter for the Chernobylite from the Farm 51 studio. This is just the tip of the iceberg of Oleksiy's multifaceted experience in the gaming industry. His dream project, Sketchcrawler, is now in Steam Early Access. And I'm ready to tell you about the adventures of the cartoon characters in the fairy tale world of this game. Sketchcrawler is a hand-drawn maze. From the first moves, I felt the spirit of the long-forgotten orcs and elves, which I played several times on the forum. But this is only the beginning. The essence of the game is that we must save the Toonkin from evil sorcerers. To do this, you will need to go through all levels with traps, anomalies, and monsters. At the start, I must choose and draw my character. With a simple graphics editor, I can create absolutely any character and animate it. Drawing is one of the main features of the game. You can draw anything, redraw characters, items, attack and defense animations. You can redraw the level. All your drawings will be used for a procedural level generation later. That is when you draw a unit in your way. All units of the same type in the future will look exactly like that. What's more, you can even voice characters and make your attack sounds. It's hard to imagine, so you have to try. I probably drew more, then ran through the levels and fought the inhabitants of the magical castle. And as far as I understood from the description, the developers are trying to achieve exactly this, to instill in the players a love of drawing through such imperfect and caricatured cartoons. Don't be afraid to express yourself. Fail and try again. Be bold in your ideas. The gameplay is based on collecting game cards that help us travel through the mazes. They allow you to cast magic spells and various attack options, and restore health, armor, and even companions. This is my first experience with such a card game, since I'm far from a fan of this genre and often bypassed such projects. But the style and the possibility of endless customization of the world Sketchcrawler captivates with its originality. Yes, this game is not for everyone, but I'm sure it will find an audience that will have fun battling cartoon goblins, ink blobs, crooked wolves, and obscure squiggles. The developers continue to improve the game by adding new card mechanics, locations, quests, and characters. It is also planned to add a system for sharing content created by players. The game is completely passable until the very end. It uses procedural level generation, has four main locations, more than 300 characters, and magic cards. This is still not a finished product. Players can help the developers with their feedback to improve and complete the game. Sketchcrawler is the world on the last page of an old math workbook with many strange drawings, games and made this a world that we would like to draw and have fun in it. Now we have such an opportunity in Sketch Crawler.